بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In this session we will talk about chapter 10, and in this chapter we will discuss how to write and how to read from files. So usually our programs, we write Java programs that will take the input from keyboard, and then once we do calculation we do our Java program, and then the output will be just displayed on screen. In chapter 10 we will learn how to take the input, just like we do the reading from keyboard. Also we can do reading from files, just for example input.txt. So if we have student data, if we have employees, if we have any data, we can do the reading from the text file, take it to our Java program, do the manipulation, the calculation, and then we can do the output on screen, on monitor, or also we can do the output and save it in another text file. For example, we calculate the average and then we do the output in another text file. So why we need to use files instead of using keyboard and monitor, just like the way we use? When you use your keyboard as input and you use your screen as output, it means the data you have used so far will be just like a temporary data. So when the program ends, the data typed at the keyboard and left on the screen will go away, so it's not saved. But when we use files, it means the data in a file remains after program execution. So whatever you calculate as average, maximum, minimum, you can save it in a file. We will start chapter 10 with how to write into a text file. So we will write a Java program, and we will do a couple of calculation, manipulation, and then when we do the output, and instead of doing an output on monitor, we will do an output on a text file. So the data will be saved in a text file, so later on we can just open the file and view the data. In order to create a text file and write into a text file, we have to have three main steps. Step number one, open the file, and that's why we need a class printWriter. So for example, we say printWriter and object out file equal new printWriter, and then between double quotation we need to specify our file name. For example, file name.txt, input.txt, whatever the file name is. This step will open the file and the file will be ready for writing. Then to be able to write into your file, just like you write on screen and you say system.out.println, here we will just refer to the name of the file. So we call it out file at the beginning. So here we will just say outfile.println, and between double quotation we will have our message. At the end, we have to remember to close the file. So we have to mention outfile.close, and this will close our file. So always the main steps are: you have to open your file for writing, so you have to use the class printWriter, and you have to give an object name. And then using this object name, you will just use it just like you use system.out. And at the end, always you have to remember to close the file by using the name of the object .close. Now let's start with a very small program where we have no files, and then we will go smoothly and modify it with files. So the program says, write a Java program to do the following. Read student ID test 1, test 2 for 30 students. So it means I need a loop for 30 students, and I will need to read ID test 1 and test 2. For each student on screen, we need to do the following output: student ID, test 1, test 2, and the average. So we have a simple input and output here. For example, we say enter a student ID test 1 and test 2, and here we have the following ID and 15 and 15 as test 1 and 2. As an output on screen, we have the ID 15 and 15, this is the two tests, and then 15, which is the average. We continue with the other student by asking for ID and two tests, which was entered as 20 and 30. So as an output, again, we will have the ID, the two tests, and then the average. And we will continue till we reach the end of 30 students. So to write this program, basically, we are reading from the keyboard and we do the output on screen. So as usual, we start with a scanner because we read from the keyboard. In the public void main, we will say scanner read equal new scanner system end. So we are reading from the keyboard here. We need to ask the user to enter marks for 30 students. That's why I need a loop from 1 to 30. I will ask the student, the user to enter ID test 1 and test 2 by using system.out. We will create three variables, ID, test 1 and test 2, and then we will do the reading as long, double and double. And then once we do the output, we will say system.out.println ID space, T1 space, T2 space, and then between a bracket, we will calculate the average of T1 plus T2 over 2. And then once we finish the 30 student, we will just close the loop and we will output a message end of a program. So this was a very basic program where you use a scanner to read from the keyboard and you have a loop to read for 30 students. And then when you do the output, you just mention system.out.println. Now let's modify it a little bit. It says here, change example 1 to write the student details ID test 1 test 2 and average into a file named student.txt instead of screen output. So in the previous program, we are reading from the keyboard the student ID test 1 test 2. We take it into the program, we calculate the average, and then once we do the output, we do it on monitor, we do it on screen. So once our program is finished, it means the data on the monitor will be removed, will be gone, and we will have no access to the average anymore. If we need the average, we need to run the program again, and only the data will be displayed on screen. Now we need to modify it such that when we do the output, we need to save it in a file. The name of the file is t.txt, so this is a text file. We have to output the student ID, test 1, test 2, and then the average. So for example, if we have these data, then this is will be the output. So if we save it in a text file, and then we close our program, then whenever we need the average, we can simply go to the text file, open it, and then we will find all the details. So this was our original program, the previous one. So we have a scanner, we have our class, we have a scanner read equal new scanner system.n. And then we have a for loop from I equal 1 till 30. We are asking the user to enter student ID, test 1 and test 2. We have three variables, we do the reading. And then once we do the output, we say system.out.println. And then we just do the output of the values. And then we just close our program. Now what do we need? We need the following. We need to do the output in a file, student.txt, such that we should have all the data, all the calculations saved over there. And to do this, we need to create an object that is pointing to this file. And that's why we need to have a statement that says, create out file as an object of a printwriter equal a new printwriter st.txt. So if you notice here, we're using a printwriter, this is a class. Outfile is a name of object equal a new writer between double quotation st.txt. st.txt, this is the name of the text file. So if this file was called mydata.txt, it means here between double quotation, I have to say mydata.txt. Now, whenever I need to refer to the file, I will refer to it by using the object name, which is outfile. So this was step number 1. Step number 2, we will just read the data as usual. So we will have 30 students. We will read the data from the keyboard. So I have to ask the user and we will read from the keyboard. Now, instead of saying system.out.println, if I do system.out, this will do the output on screen. I need to do the output in the file, which we are calling it outfile. So I have to do the following. I will change it. Instead of saying system.out.println, we will say outfile.println. So this outfile is just used there. A print line, go and just write the data in my file. This is a step 2. Step number 3 is Once you finish your loop, you finish all the data, remember you need to close your file. So you have to say outfile.close and this will close your file. So you open a file and you call it outfile. Whenever you need to write, you will say outfile.println. Once you finish, you have to say outfile.close. Now, because we are dealing with file, we need to add a try and catch. So that's why whenever here we have a print file, we are opening the file and we will need to write into a file. I have to have a try opening bracket and after the close, we will have the closing bracket of the try block. Why we need a try in this case? If you remember from the previous chapter, we mentioned we use a try and catch if we expect unusual event in our program. So for example here, let's assume we are trying to open a file st.txt and this file is a read-only file or this file is not accessed by any way. It means the file will not be open and we will have an error. So we cannot do any writing. We cannot say outfile.println, which means the whole thing will not be executed. The whole thing will not be done. And that's why I need to have it within a try. So we will have the try, and at the end of the try, I should have here catch, and I will say IO exception, which is input output exception. And we will just simply have a message system.out.println. We have an error e.getMessage. e.getMessage will display what type of message. Is it a read-only file? Is it access deny? Is the disk is full? So we cannot do writing to the file. So all what we need to do is we need the try block and we need the catch block. And the main aim of a try is if I have any error in opening my file, automatically it will go to the catch. It will handle the exception. It will display a message. So it will never ask for any details and the program will just stop over there. Also, we have to remember because we are using a print writer and because we are using IO exception, just like at the beginning, we have import Java utility scanner. I have Java IO print writer. We have also Java IO exception. So these are the main steps when you are trying to write into a file. So step number one, remember you need a print writer, call it an object, and then you have the file between double quotation. Just do your program normally. When you need to write to a file, you have to mention the file name dot print line. And then at the end, you have to say outfile.close. Because you are dealing with file, always you should have a try and always you should have catch. The main aim of a try is if this file cannot be open for any reason, the compiler will automatically go to catch and will display a message. And by that, we make sure that our program is running and we are not having any error or any unusual event. And also we have to remember to include the library, Java IO print writer, Java IO exception. When we try to write to a file, we just have to note the following. Whenever we open a text file for output, we always begin with an empty file. So if no existing file has the given name, the constructor will create an empty file with that name. But if an existing file has the given name, all of the data will be eliminated and the new output will be returned to the existing file. So it means like this. If you are trying to write to a file, file student.txt, and the file does not exist, there is no such file, then a new file will be created, a new empty file, and your data will be returned to that file. But if your file exists, there is already a file called the student.txt, which means the old data will be removed. So you will not keep the old data, but it will be empty and a new data will be written over there.